ICTD has brought together researchers and policymakers from around the world to discuss potentially the biggest reform to the way that countries tax multinational companies in 100 years. We want to understand how it will affect developing countries, what room there is for them to influence it, and the risks and opportunities that they face.
There was always a need to revisit the rules of allocation of income between developed and developing countries. The rules that we have nowadays date from the beginning of the last century, and therefore businesses have moved in a way that the allocation of income as it is currently does not correspond to where actually business activities take place and where value is created.
The stakes for developing countries are extremely high because we are trying to rework the international tax system, which was designed a century ago when developing countries did not have their say. A lot of them were colonies.
We've struggled, first of all, to understand what our place is in this economy, in the digitalized economy, and to understand exactly what value it is that companies are deriving from Uganda, and if indeed we can even tax them. And we've attempted to engage the multinational companies involved in this industry in a dialogue, but they quite simply won't respond to us, possibly because we are too small. So the conversations here, where we are discussing a global solution to this issue, and we believe that a global solution might bring them to the table a lot faster than if Uganda approaches them as one country.
Developing countries should be more involved in the process, especially both in the UN and then those who are members of the inclusive framework should be actively involved, understand the principles and the issues, and ensure that their interests are taken into account.
I think this is a good example of how it should be done. We had the OECD come and present, we had people from the IMF, we had people from the UN. That was quite interesting. They made an effort to bring in people from Africa, people from South America, and people from developing countries, and we had an enriching discussion where everyone was able to discuss issues pertaining to tax and the digital economy from their own perspective. And I think that is something that contributes to what an inclusive framework should be.